Welcome to RNBO. I've been a Max user now for over two decades, and although I didn't know its name, RNBO is something that I've spent many hours dreaming about. For a long time, I've wished for the flexibility that RNBO brings, like taking my patch to standalone hardware, sharing it in a web page or as a plugin, and being able to take my patch and share it back with the community as an object. RNBO makes all of this possible for me, and here's how I did it. In teaser one, I wanted to hit a few points that I feel are important to RNBO. I wanted to show its flexibility, both relating to hardware and to software, and what better way to do it than putting a RNBO patch on a cheap device such as the Raspberry Pi and trekking out to the National Forest to play around with it. It's a place I'd think twice about before taking my laptop. I wanted to create a sound synonymous with Max, using something like Buffer Shuffler, chopping up a legendary sample such as Jungly, and mashing it all back together. Since everything in Gen runs inside of RNBO, I fast-tracked this by taking the Gen Chucker remake from the built-in Gen examples. Chucker is the key object of Buffer Shuffler, and I shoehorn this into RNBO. This particular patch needed a few modifications to satisfy my requirements of being both generative and able to function on a Raspberry Pi. Another important addition I needed to make was generating an internal buffer of steps so that my Chucker emulation could reshuffle the sample. I leveraged an outlet from the Gen patcher to trigger the generation of a new buffer of randomly shuffled steps. This adds a nice generative self-playing remix element to this patcher. Let's take a listen. I decided to use the Pi sound, as it's one of the best Raspberry Pi solutions. It also comes in this nice case, which makes the whole setup both portable and tough out there in the National Forest. Let's take a quick look at exporting our Chucker Shuffler RNBO patch over to the Pi sound. In our patch, hit the Show Export sidebar. I'm going to select my Raspberry Pi. Now the key setting here is the copy sample dependencies, and this makes sure that Jungly, our sample that we chop up in this patcher, is transferred along with the RNBO patch over to the Pi sound. And then when the Pi sound fires up, Jungly can be chopped and mashed generatively by our patch. Okay, so that's by default. We don't need to change anything there. And now let's hit the export to selected target. And there's our code doing its thing, heading over to the Raspberry Pi. Successfully exported to target. For teaser two, I wanted to show a RNBO made plugin on a cheap DAW on the cheapest laptop that I could purchase at Costco. And I wanted to get up and running with that laptop as quickly as possible. Here I am in RNBO. I have a copy of the track that I used in the teaser, and I'm trying it out directly with my RNBO patcher before I turn it into a plugin. With this crossfade parameter, you can hear the effect that the RNBO patch has on the original sound. These parameters inside the RNBO patcher allow me to access the control of them from the top level Max patch as attribute UI objects. I can control these by hand, and I can make presets and snapshots of them. These parameters will automatically become controls in my exported plugin, including the range and default values I declared when I originally made them in RNBO. This version of the patch has a small overdrive section. It's a little aggressive, so I'm going to remove it before I export my final plugin. Now I'm ready to export my plugin. Open the export sidebar and select Audio Plugin Export. Now you might have noticed that I'm developing this on a Mac when I intend to take the plugin over to a Windows laptop. You can see here in the Format and Platform dropdown that I can build my plugin in four different formats, regardless of the system I'm on. I can do this because the export process sends the RNBO patch up to a cloud compiler, and then an online toolchain takes the compiled RNBO patch and converts it into a plugin format that I selected in this process. Once this is completed, the plugin is downloaded back to my machine and I can put it into the relevant plugin folder. I'll name my plugin, set a manufacturer name and plugin type, and I'll leave everything else set at its default settings. Once my plugin has exported, I'll move it over to my Windows laptop where I need to put it in this folder. This way, Reaper will see it when I start it up next. Being able to include a sample or generate audio in the browser is a first for Macs and not previously possible before RNBO. In this teaser, I wanted to show coming across a random link online and being booby-trapped by the sound it generates. I had the idea here to make something with a single control point that would get louder as the slider moved and decimate the sound into something pretty obnoxious. At least enough to get me in trouble at most libraries. I used this improvised vocal sample. Let's take a listen to what it sounds like. Now let's hear it through my RNBO patcher. There are two params, a ping that starts the sample playback out of groove and a param called 11 that ramps everything to 11. This parameter controls several points. The parameter is simultaneously multiplying the signal out of groove, downsampling the resolution inside of gen, and then adding an LFO using cycle tilde onto the output. It's then being soft clipped through Tarnhage and then runs out through Limi to ensure that the final output stays under Unity. Now you'll see here that we have a buffer and that we've set the add file attribute just like we did in teaser 1 to make sure the sample is included in our web target export. Let's export it. Now you'll see that the export just gives us the basics with no UI. And I'm not a front-end guy, so here's where I tap the shoulder of my good buddy Sam to help me make a single slider UI that I can link my parameter called 11 to, with the idea here to make the UI look like a Mac slider with a bit of a twist. Sam, can you show me how you made the crazy slider and how we linked it to the web code that I exported?
Sure, Tom, I'd be happy to. So it all starts with this JavaScript web page template available on the RNBO website. This is a single page web application you can export your RNBO code into and see how it sounds in the browser. I modified this page just adding the slider as an SVG element with a few rectangles. The meat of what's actually going on to the handlers for that slider, I attach this function updateValueForEvent that's just checking if there's a device, and then if there is, getting that parameter 11 and setting its value to be the value of the slider. So that's how you control that param from the web page. And then just to add a little bit of sauce, there's this function here that checks how far up you've dragged the slider and adds a little bit of noise to its position getting more intense as you make the slider, you know, go up and up in value. So it makes it look like the slider is shaking a bit as you really crank that parameter up to 11. So really not much more to it than that. And if you wanted to make your own crazy slider, that's how you do it.
Thanks, Sam. Here's where we ended up. For the final teaser, I wanted to show that it's now possible to take any RNBO patch and easily turn it into a Max external. I returned to the Chaka emulation patch that I used in teaser one, but with some final modifications to the patch. I added some controls so that rather than being generative, I now have the ability to stop and start the sound. And I also added a filter from the RNBO synth building blocks. Making a Max external in the past required coding in C or C++, but now I can export my RNBO patch as a Max external directly out of RNBO without writing any code. This export process combines my RNBO code with the Min SDK in the cloud compiler and churns out a Max external for either Mac or Windows, regardless of the machine I'm working on. The external by default is automatically downloaded into a folder inside my documents called RNBO Generated. You can find it here. Once my external has completed the build process, it's automatically available to be patched directly inside of Max. Now, RNBO is out in the world, and I look forward to seeing what you do with it.